What the fuck is up, guys? Hopefully my mic's on. Yes it is. Anyway, what is up, guys? I am back. I have been gone, as you may know, for a long time. I can actually check for you. Besides the video that I uploaded just now, titled WTF Rockstar, I have not uploaded 3 weeks. So I've decided today I'm gonna upload a video. It's gonna be a 2-in-1 video, so at the end I'm going to be talking about why I haven't been here. But pretty much the gist of this video is I felt like doing I don't know what to call shit anymore, okay? I'm showing you my cars, okay? What they sound like, how good they are, the reason why I've got them, simple as that. And we're just going to get right into it. Okay, first car we have is the Rune Chibarek. It's a Russian style car. That's the main reason I fucking got it. It's a pretty cool car to drive around. It looks basic, but I enjoy that. It isn't the fastest car in the game by fucking far, but it's a nice car in my opinion. We can pop the hood so you guys can see what it looks like. Bang. Look at that fucking beast gun. Holy, okay. We're gonna listen to the startup. Alright, let's listen to it. Woo! Listen to that baby purr! Alright, we're gonna do a bit of a launch. We're gonna drive from here to the end. And we're gonna swap cars. This car cost me 100-something thousand. It's a nice car. Yeah. Like I said, not the fastest, but for what it is pretty fucking fast. Fuck. Okay. Anyway, moving on to the next car. Alrighty, next car we got here is the Italia GTO. I feel like it's a staple car because, number one, it's one of the fastest sports cars that rivals the fastest sports cars. It's faster than most supercars. It's got a very slick design. I haven't done much visually to it. Literally all I've done, okay, minus the scratches, sorry about that. all I've really done is change the color, change the interior, change the engine. It was yellow, and I changed it to carbon because I feel like it looks more, like, cooler. Anyways, that's the engine. And I changed the wheels. The only thing I did with the wheels is I found what the default ones were. Because, and I pretty much put them on because the default ones had like tire riding on it. I didn't like that. Anyway, the reason why I got this car is because it's one of my, it's similar to one of the cars that I want in real life, like one of my dream cars, which is the Ferrari 812. I'm pretty sure this one's based off. It's very similar to the Ferrari, like, I fucking forget what the model is. It's 458 is the one I want, which is very similar to this as well. But yeah, that's the main reason why I got this, because it's fast, it's similar to a car that I want, and yeah, I like it. Yeah, we're gonna hear the startup sounds. Sounds good, rev it up a bit. We can do a bit of a launch and we'll move on to the next car. Next up, lads, is the lowrider, which everyone has to have. Okay, it's not everyone has to have a lowrider. Well, this lowrider, everyone has to have at least one lowrider. The lowrider I chose was the Willard Factory Custom. It's custom because it's a lowrider. Anyways, I wanted this car. I found this car. I liked it. I didn't realize I had a lowrider variant until later, but I had it with the purple color on it and the white wheels. I liked that. And we got the engine upgrade here, which gave it a V8 with the twin turbo. We've also got hydraulics on it. I'll showcase that in a bit. That's the hydraulics in the back with the speakers. Got the interior here. Underglow, I had to have the yellow with the purple yellow. Very royal elegant colors. Got the cheetah, the white cheetah in interior here. And if we hop in, you'll be able to see. We got an ornament there. Got the Westside logo in the back, as well as the thing there, which is a microphone, because why not? Anyway, so we're gonna close all the stuff on here, and we're gonna hear the startup and show off the hydraulics. Ooh. I will turn that off. Alright, so hydraulics. You know, always gotta have the hydraulics on, you know. Bang. Alright. Fun fact, driving like this, slow. Driving with your hydraulics all the way down, slow. Driving like this though is the fastest you can be. So let's get a This is one of my more visually impressing cars, because it's obviously done up the most. It's a lowrider. One of my personal favourites out of the lot. It'd have to be, like, yeah, this is easily like one of my favourite cars that I've got. Yeah, let's move on to the next car. Next car we got here is the Gauntlet Hellfire. Really nice car. It's fucking, I did like pretty much nothing visually to it except put the stripes on. I kept the wheel stock because I like those rims. I want to change this hood. I haven't got around to it, but I want to change it to a flat hood because, sure, it looks cool when the car's running, but when you want to, you know, pop the hood, it looks kind of whack. So, yeah. It's obviously based off the Hellcat. I got this car from the podium. I wanted to just, you know, fucking buy it, but it was on a podium, so I just, I bared the hours, not the hours, I took it like 4 days and I finally got it. Yeah, I really enjoy this car. It's pretty good, it sounds nice. Fucking, it's a drifting mobile, bro. I use, it's like, if someone was like, oh, we're having a drift meet, I'm whipping this shit out, I'm drifting. Yeah, no doubt about it. Alright, so, let's hear the launch, we'll, I hear the startup, hear the launch, let's go. Listen to that engine. Wham, 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 wham. Ignore me, autistic sounds. Anyway, let's hit a launch. The thing I hate about this car, I don't know whether it's just me not knowing how to launch it, but whenever I try to launch it like this... Oh, never mind, I hit it. I hit it, boys. Alright, never mind. Alright, that's the first time I actually hit like a decent launch on this car. But yeah, usually I can't hit the launch on it very well. But yeah, let's move on to the next car. Okay, here with the next car, which is the SHAREfactory V12. I've got the armored edition because you've always got to have that protection in case the press is coming to blow you up. You can last at least one hit with the armored plating. Nothing really on the car is stock, as you can clearly tell. Got the spoiler, got the awesome exhaust in there. These rims. I was a fan of them back then. I couldn't be bothered changing them, they're slowly growing on me. I have the carbon hood, the nice purple, with the white interior. Very clean, very elegant. The reason why I bought the car is because it's armored, it's four door, so for whatever reason, we all decided to cruise in one car. Cruising this, it's like one of the fastest, I'm pretty sure. It sounds fucking beasty. It also kind of reminds me of a car that I want to buy. Which, if you don't live in Australia, you probably won't understand. This Holden Commodore looks similar to it, in my opinion. That's why I bought it, really. But yeah, let's hear the startup, hear the launch, and we'll get on to the next car. If you tell me that doesn't sound nice, I'll fucking eat you, bro. This... Oh, I can't. One problem with this car is it's quite... You can drift it, it's just pretty difficult because of how, like, wide it, like, long it is and shit. So you can't really hit like good drift train. Yeah, you can't hit good like drift trains and shit on it. Anyway, let's move on to the next car. Next up, lads, we got the all gold Benefactor Dubster over here. Why did I get it in all gold? Because I thought it looked nice. The rims, and the issue with the rims is I couldn't get a color that kind of like matched the gold like perfectly. That's like the closest I could find. Probably just lazy. All the the add-ons like the sidestep, the roof racks, the lights, the fucking thing on the front, thing on the back, all chrome, and they've got to stick with the shiny feel, all blacked out tint. Why did I get this car? Because it looks nice. Why wouldn't I? No, it's just a nice looking car to like cruise around in. Obviously had to have the snorkel on here. Sounds alright. It's decently fast for like what type of car it is. Got it. Another reason I got it is because it kind of looks like a G-Wagon, so why the fuck not? But let's hit the start up and the launch, and we'll move on to the next car. See, basic. See, it doesn't sound too bad. Fucking SUV. And once it hits speed, bro, it's actually like quite fast. If you ask me, I feel like it's pretty fast. But yeah, let's move on to the next car. Next car, we got the Mamba. I got the topless because, alright, story. This was, it was the first car I won off the podium. I didn't actually want it at first. Once I did it up and like started driving around, realized how nice of a car it was, I really, really like, I'm glad I didn't sell it. Visually, there's not much you can actually do to this car except change the livery color, choose whether it's a roof or not, pardon the voice crack, and the rims. The rims I recently just changed because I don't know why, but I for some reason at first liked the stock rims. They look fucking bleh, and I decided to change them. This car, in my opinion, one of the best sounding cars in the game. So we're gonna hear that. Why did I get it? Well, because it was a podium car. If I sold it, I would have got nothing for it. So like, fuck it, might as well keep it now. See, I got the matte black with the flames on it, because why not? And let's hear the start up and the launch. See, tell me that doesn't sound nice. It's also like, if you can control it, it's a really good drift car. I used to be able to, but not much anymore. Yeah, let's move on. Next car we got here is the Conquette. I don't know how to say it, I'm just going to refer to it as the Corvette, because that's pretty much what it is. Based off the Corvette Z05, if I'm not mistaken, which is dream car of mine. And this, pretty much, like this blue here, is pretty much what I've built here is dream car. Like, if I got this in real life, I'd fucking shit my pants. Nah, I'm joking, but it probably would. Anyway, literally the only reason why I got this is because it's dream car. It's a nice car. Not the fastest, because obviously why would it be? There's so many other fast cars out there. But it's not a bad car. I enjoy driving it around. I would recommend people buy it if they're looking for like a nice looking car with decent speed on it. Sounds pretty good, so let's do that. It doesn't sound that bad. Could be better. But yeah. If I tried, I could probably drift this thing around, but I'm still getting used to like its handling and shit. This is one of my newer additions to like the garage and shit. But yeah, move on to the next car. Next car, I'm pretty sure everyone fucking owns, but this is the LG Retro Custom. Why did I get it? It's a Skyline. I had to make it look like Paul Walker's Skyline. The livery was there, all the options were there. The spoiler, this is the closest spoiler you can get to it. Pretty much everything is probably as close as you could ever get to it. Have a look at the inside. I don't want to hop in because it'll ruin the launch, but I'll probably do it anyways once we launch it, start it up. Is we got the turbo dials, all the dials in there are blue. We got the blue underglow because it's Paul Walker Skyline. So yeah, fucking if you don't own one of these, you're dumb. It's based off the R34, I'm pretty sure. Like, I'm 90% sure it's based off the R34. Not much else I can say about this car, honestly. Except let's hear it. Sounds nice. Listen to that. Alright, actually, the one downside to this car, it's got to do with how it drives. It's an all-wheel drive, so it can't drift. Why? Why the fuck would you, like... Anyway, let's just launch it. Like, you can't actually drift properly. You can probably power glide. You can't even do that. Actually, I'll show you one more thing. Got that blue tire spoke, because why not? Anyway, let's move on to the next car. Alright, next up, the car I'm sure everyone was waiting to see. Oh, I want to do the job, but I can't. Trying to move it. Fuck. Back to what I was saying. The car I'm sure everyone was waiting to see. The Pariah, the Ocelot Pariah, the statistically the fastest car in the game at this point in time as of the 3rd of December, 2019. Yeah, what else can I say? The reason I got it is because it's the fastest car in the game. And if anyone ever offers me out to a race, I'll guess them. It sounds pretty nice. Most people don't like the design of it. I personally do. Like, I actually really, like, except the back end. Like, it could look better, but I wouldn't even complain about the fastest car. Not all cars look good. Let's hear the starter. Alrighty, hit it launch and we'll move on to the next car. So the difference between this car and the Italia GTO is the fact that, number one, this one is a much easier to drift. This one has a higher top speed, while the other one has like a faster acceleration. Pretty sure it's like very like minimal, but it is faster accelerating. So in a short run, the Pariah would probably lose, depending on the driver really. But in the long run, it would win easily. But once again, it all comes down to the driver. Anyway, let's move on to the next car. Next up, we have the Imponte Duke. So I also have the Duke of Death, which I'm not going to show because it's pretty much exactly the same as this car here, except it sounds a bit different, I've noticed. But anyway, the reason why I got this is because it's Challenger. I can make it look like Dom's Challenger. Why the fuck not? It was also free, so I thought I'd buy it, do it up a bit. It's pretty fast, sounds nice. It's a fucking complete animal. You don't really see it that often, which is kind of like surprising because of how good it is. But yeah, we'll hit a startup and we'll do a launch. See, listen to that engine, bro. Alright, let's hit a launch real quick and then we'll move on to the next car. I fucked up the launch a bit there, but it's a pretty good car. Alright, let's move on. So, next car is the, I'm not sure, I know it's the Stallion, I don't know if it's the Classy or whatever it is. Anyways, it's the Stallion, okay. I got it because it was free, it looks nice, it sounds nice. Nothing much to it. Visually, the only thing I did is, when you buy it, it comes with the roof off. I just put the roof on. That's the only visual change I've done to it. Let's hear the startup. It's a very like classic looking car, which is like, I like this, like the simplistic design of it. I fucked up the drift anyways. Let's move on to the next car. Alrighty, I'm not gonna spend too much time on this because this is the wrong version of the LG RH8 that I've got. I've got a stock version here. I kept it because I bought it and it didn't come with the spoiler. Because I accidentally bought two because I thought I lost my other one, but I just had it in a different garage. And so, pretty much, like, most of the time when I buy them, they come with a spoiler. I kept this one because it didn't come with a spoiler. So I was like, fuck it, like, it looks clean without it. It doesn't really need it. So I'm not going to do, like, a start. I might do a startup, and that's it. And I'm just going to move on to the other LG, and we'll do a startup and a launch on that one because it's actually done up properly. And yeah, so here's the startup. Not bad. But yeah, this car's also free, by the way, for Rockstar Central Club members. But yeah, let's move on to my actual done up LG RH8. Alrighty, here we are with the actual done up LG RH8 that I've got, the standard one, not the retro custom. So yeah, this is free for social club members. All you have to do is sign up, link it to your whatever console you play it on, Xbox, PlayStation, Steam, whatever. Link it to your social club. And then once you log back in, go into Legendary Motorsports or Benny's. You'll find the car, it literally says free, you can buy it. It's a pretty nice car, it's reliable, especially considering low level players can use it and they aren't fucking in complete garbage cars. They're in a really nice car. I see a lot of like high level people still drive this around. This is one of the first cars that I actually did up like fully. But yeah, let's listen to the startup on this and we'll launch it. So not much of like a sound difference, maybe a little bit. You can obviously hear the turbo. But yeah, let's hit the launch on this. like I said, it's a pretty good car for like the lower level players because they have a reliable, fast sports car that, you know, can get them around the map pretty quick. But yeah, let's move on to the next car. Next vehicle is the Karakara 4x4. It's a big ute fucking thing. I've done nothing visually to it. I wanted off the podium. The only thing I've done really is added that roll bar. That's it. I haven't even lowered the suspension. I've seen some people do it. It looks disgusting. Actually, I think I changed the front bumper a bit. And I haven't done much to the rear. It's just a really nice car. It's pretty fast. It sounds pretty decent. And it's a big ute thing car. Of course I'm gonna keep it. Go off-road and bush bashing in a car, so let's go. Woo! See, it sounds fucking nice, bro. Like, you can't tell me it doesn't. If you tell me it doesn't sound nice, you're on drugs. Obviously, it can't drift, whatever, but yeah, we'll just move on to the next car. The next car, the Ocelot Swinger. This was a car I went off the podium. I got it because I went off the podium. Stop liking my TikToks. Anyway, yeah, so at first I didn't like it. This is actually a video I uploaded a while ago where I won it 2 days in a row. So I won it the first day it came out and then I won it the second day. I didn't like it at first because it purely off the looks. I didn't really like the look of it. Like, I like the color, I still like the shape of it and shit like that. The more and more I drove it, I like the sound of it, I like it, it's pretty quick. It's just overall, it's a really nice car. I regret not liking it. But anyways, let's do the startup and we'll move on to the next car. Perfect. See, like, it sounds pretty good. And it is a race car, so it can't really drift very well. I'll try though. Okay, I'll take that back, it's actually not bad at drifting. Anyway, let's move on to the next car. Up, can't. Alrighty, next up we got the fucking Carrion Futo. So this is my riced out anime version. I gotta make a more clean drift build, but everyone has to have a Futo in the garage. You can literally steal off the street, you can buy for 9,000. Whatever floats your boat, whatever sinks your fucking plane, can't, honestly. I got the anime variant because it's riced out and it's very jazz friendly. Yeah, I like the car, it's a fucking drift machine. But yeah, we'll listen to the startup, we'll fucking launch it and put a drift. Boom! Oh, I still got the pink underglow, so we'll take off the light. Perfect! Woof! Launch! We'll try and hit a good drift and, you know, drag it out for a sec. And let's hit that. Alright, I fucked up the drift, but yeah. So this isn't the fastest car, but it's a nice drifting car, it's a fucking Futo. It sounds good, it drives good, it is an anime car. And let's move on to the next. And we're back with another weeb fucking weebmobile. with the Sultan RS, which is the Bentley's upgrade to the Sultan, based off the WRX. I'm pretty sure, I'm not 100% sure it's based off Subaru WRX anyways. Got it because I had the Sultan and I wanted the Super Moon, like I wanted the upgrade of it. And I got the anime variant because the fucking the delivery was there, why not? Sounds nice, drives nice, riced out once again because it's anime, had to see the startup of the launch. Sounds nice. It's pretty much a polar opposite because it's all-wheel drive, so I can't fucking drift. I can try, but can't guarantee anything good. Yeah, so you can't even fucking chain drifts and dual power slide, and that's it, bro. Anyways, it is pretty fast. It's got good traction. It's pretty much a racing car. We've got like three cars left, but let's get into it. We're back with one of the final cars in my car list. We have got the Piss Wasser Vapid Dominator. It was free to me as a returning player, so I got it. One of the fast, I'm pretty sure it's the fastest muscle car. I got this version because it was free. Why the fuck not? There's nothing visual you can really do to it. It's a nice car. It's pretty much a Mustang. It fucking launches well. It's quick. What else do you want from a car? Bang. Sounds fucking beastie. Let's try and hit a good launch, which we got a decent launch on that. It's not bad at drifting either. If I can get it here. See, look at that. Look at that. That's fucking... Oh my god. I guess you could say that's quite... Atomic, nah, look out. Anyway, moving on, next car. And we are back with the Daniel Morgan. Alright, we are back with the white pedo van, which is called the Vapid Rumpo, I believe. I got this because I found it on the side of the street. Looked like a pedo van. I am a pedo. No joke, joking, I am not a pedo, but I took it because I like vans. Anyway, let's hear the epic engine startup on this. Oh, listen to that. Oh, look at that speed. Oh, it's fucking quick. Oh, ready? Let's hit this drift. I call this sliding into the six-year-old's DMs. Alright, let's move on to the last car. Fuck them. And we're back with the last car, which is actually the newest addition to my garage. This is the Ocelot. I think it's the Fathom... P something something something, some random numbers. Anyway, it's based off some sort of Jaguar, and I like Jaguars. I like the color. I picked this color. It is sea green. It looks nice. I don't give a fuck what you have to say. It sounds nice. It's a street car. I took it up the street. I did it up. I took it down. Boom. We'll listen to the startup. We'll launch it. It's a coupe. You hear that? It growled like me. Yeah, I don't know what it's called. It's Ocelot. Fucking, I think it's like P26Q, I don't know. ABCDEFG algebra. Listen to that. For a street fucking car, bro. And we launched that shit. We're trying to hit a fat drift. My number plate says 69. Oh, Lord. That's pretty funny. Oh, it's actually shit at drifting. Okay, never mind. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching this shitty little video. I had nothing to upload, so I was like, fuck it, I'll just do like a garage tour in a way, just car showcase of all the cars I've got. I will be uploading another video. This will be up tomorrow, which will be the 4th. I'm recording it on the 3rd, it'll be up on the 4th. I'll also be uploading a video tomorrow, well, the next day after that, which will be the 5th, which will most likely be a Dauntless video. If you guys don't know, I haven't uploaded any Dauntless footage, but I have defeated all the behemoths at least once, and I'm slowly working towards maxing everything out. But for the thing that most of you guys are probably here for, the reason why I haven't been uploading, number one, literally, a couple weeks back, I graduated. So, what's today? Tuesday. So, yeah, like, 2 weeks ago, I graduated school. And I've just been chilling, you know, just, you know, living life, getting rid of my depression and shit. Yeah, just vibing, bro. Literally what my boy just said. I've just been straight up vibing. And, you know, I just haven't really been focusing on YouTube because, I don't know, I was doing other stuff, you know, I was just chilling, vibing. I passed the vibe check a few times. And, yeah, so, there's not really a good reason for me not uploading, really. I might stop YouTube depending on how all this fucking copper shit or whatever it's called. I don't know if Australia is going to be affected by it. I think we will, but if for whatever reason these cunts think, oh, your footage is, you make child-friendly content. I don't know how the fuck they come up with that idea, but if they were to, every video that I deem unchild-friendly and ACS child-friendly, it will cost like 42k per video. And I don't know if you know this, but I don't have 42k, otherwise my video qualities will be fucking top tier, my brother. So, yeah, I'll be uploading, I'll try and upload daily as much as I can. If I miss a day, then I'll apologize, I think. I don't know. This shit's kind of like a hobby to me at the moment. I might take it seriously in the future. I might start streaming on Twitch, because I still can't stream on fucking YouTube. For whatever reason, I'm blocked from streaming. And it's kind of annoying, but we'll get over it eventually. Hopefully, guys, accept my apology for not uploading and stuff. Like I said, I'll try and upload daily. Just struggle is trying to get good content. And remembering, hey, you have footage, record it. So, yeah. Other than that, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I don't know how long it's going to be. Probably be like 20, 30 minutes. If you didn't make it to the end, comment, hashtag... snitch night. No, I don't fucking know. Hashtag my balls are itchy. If you've made it to the end of the video, suck my balls, lick my dick, eat my ass, pull out my hairs, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, like the video. If you didn't like it, dislike it. Fucking tell me what I can improve on, what I've done wrong. My first decent video in a while. Probably wouldn't even be decent knowing my luck. Anyway. If you do want to see more, for whatever reason you want to see more of my content, subscribe, and I will hopefully be seeing you guys whenever I upload another video. Alright, also, before I leave actually, any suggestions, comments, tell me, what do you want to see? If you want me to make like a games video of all the games that I've got available to me right now, I can let you know. You guys can tell me what you want to see, and I'll upload that to the best of my ability. I'm a rap, whatever. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy your Christmas, whatever. Try not to catch AIDS, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.